Joseph was his father's favorite son. Yes, do you remember what his dad gave him to show that Joseph was the favorite? A few weeks back we talked about that. His dad gave him something extra special and it showed that he was the favorite. Allie?
It was a jacket.
A jacket or a special coat. It had lots of colors in it. And that was extra fancy, especially way back then. Colors were not easy to have like they are today. So Joseph had a special coat, and so he was his father's favorite, and his brothers hated him. Can anybody remember another reason why his brothers hated him? We were telling you last week about something that Joseph, one more reason. This front row is, they must have been paying attention last week. You already got to answer. Did you get to answer yet?
No.
Okay, so let's let you. And if she gets it wrong, then you can correct. What's that? What was the question? The question was another reason that Joseph's brothers hated him. He had some dreams. Is that what you were going to say? Joseph had these dreams, remember?
Yeah.
He dreamt that they were out and each of his brothers in his dream or representation of his brothers bowed down to him. Now, who bows down to somebody else? We bow down before God, yeah, but on the earth. Like we bow down to kings, a ruler, the people who are the subjects, the ones that obey, bow down to the ones that are given the rules out, right? So, and was Joseph older or younger than his brothers?
Younger.
He was younger. He was the youngest. Well, he had a younger brother even. But he was pretty much the youngest. One of the youngest. But he had this dream saying that his brothers were going to bow down to him. He had
10
plus a younger brother from his own mom. 11 brothers and one sister that we know of. big family. And 10 of his brothers, they did not like him. They hated him. And so, when we left Joseph, what was he doing? Remember what he was doing last week? Remember? His dad sent him to do something. Josh, what did his dad send him to do? To find his brothers. That's right. And so Joseph left his home and went off all by himself, even though it was dangerous, and he went looking for his brothers. His brothers were a long way away, right? And he went looking for them. And his brothers, where are his brothers? Oh, here they are. His brothers had the sheep, right? His brothers had the sheep and the goats and the cows, and they were a long way away. And they thought they were doing just fine. Their dad didn't know for sure what was up with them, and so he sent Joseph to find his brothers and make sure everything was okay. And so the brothers there, they were there watching the sheep and the cows and the goats and everything. And pretty soon, somebody looks off and they see somebody coming. And I think, who's that? Oh, look at that coat. Oh, it's Joseph. And what do you think they started doing? He's a long way away. I'm sure they started talking about how they didn't like Joseph, right? They didn't like Joseph. They said, he thinks he's going to rule us. He's got that fancy coat. He's got these dreams. You know what we should do? We should just kill him. Their hatred, if you hate somebody, the Bible says that's like, Jesus said, if you hate somebody without a cause, that's like murder. We should never hate someone. They hated their brother, and they hated him so much, some of the 10 were like, let's just get rid of him. And we can just kill him, we'll throw him in a pit. No one will ever know what happened to him. We can just rip that fancy coat off of him, let it, you know, do something, and we'll be rid of him. Now the oldest brother, his name was Reuben. The oldest brother, he said, you know what, guys? He didn't like the idea of killing him. He didn't like Joseph, but he didn't want to kill him. He said, let's do this. There's an empty well here. Let's just throw him in this well. And that'll teach them. Teach them to keep dreaming about being greater than us and all that. And so Reuben was his name. Reuben was the oldest. He said, let's just throw him in the well. And the guy said, okay, yeah. We might feel bad if we actually killed him. So Reuben left. He went off to do something, check on some of the animals or something. He went off somewhere else. And Joseph is still coming, and he figured out that it was brothers. And so he comes up to his brothers, and what do you think Joseph is saying? Hey, guys, how are things going? Dad's been wondering where you are. I'm so glad to see you. He might have looked around and said, what's Reuben off doing? And what did his brothers do? I don't know exactly how, but they kind of probably just kind of got all surrounded him, right? Make sure he couldn't leave. And then they started grabbing him. They were probably pulling on his jacket. And he was like, hey, you're going to rip the coat, Dad. Yeah, exactly. We want to rip the coat. Who do you think you are? Thinking that you're going to rule over us in your smarty pants with your fancy dreams and all of that stuff. And they grabbed him and they threw him down in a hole. It was a well that didn't have any water in it. Put him down in the well. And they just let him sit there. And they went off and sat around and kept talking. So Joseph is down in the well by himself. He's crying out, hey guys, I thought, what is going on? And he was upset, and they were up there, and they took care of him. We'll see what happens to his dreams. After a little bit, somebody said, man, I'm hungry. So they got some food, they were eating there. Joseph was down there crying out for help, hoping somebody would come along and rescue him. Now, he didn't know Reuben was going to come back later. Remember the one that said, put him in the pit? He thought, I'll come back later after the brothers are gone, and I'll get them out of the pit, and I'll say, hey, now hopefully you learned your lesson. Go home and stop talking about your fancy dreams. So that's what Reuben was thinking. But he was not there. And so while they were there, while he was gone, The other nine brothers, right? The other nine brothers, they're eating, they're having a good time. Joseph's down in the pit crying and just hoping somebody will come along and hear his yelling and screaming and get him out of there. And Judah, one of the other brothers, saw some people traveling by. Now back then they didn't have cars and semi-trucks. They put all their stuff on camels. And so he saw a caravan, a bunch of camels with a bunch of stuff on it, and could tell they were heading toward Egypt. Obviously, they had all kinds of stuff that they had bartered for wherever they had been before, and they were taking all this stuff down to the big, rich country of Egypt to sell it. And that way, they could make some money. That's just what they did. They were merchantmen. They were traders. They traded things. And so Judah said, hey, exactly. They said, we don't even need to kill him. If we kill him, we'll feel bad about it. Let's just take him and sell him. Then he's not dead, but he's out of our hair forever. And we'll get some money for him. So they got Joseph out of the pit. They took him down to the traders, the merchantmen, and they said, look, we got a slave here that we don't need him anymore. He's strong and he's young, but we don't need him anymore. How much will you give us for it? And they went back and forth. Finally, they agreed that they could, that the merchantmen agreed that they would buy Joseph for 20 pieces of silver. So that's, I don't know how much that is, but silver is pretty valuable. So how many is that per guy? 20 divided by 10. It's like 2 pieces of silver each. 20 pieces of silver. It says it's a deal. And so Joseph, tied up like a slave, went with those people. And he was heading toward Egypt. What's going to happen to him now? That's trouble, isn't it?
Yes.
That, don't. You've been reading ahead. Don't ruin it. You have to come back next week and see what happens to him. But listen, we're not done. So, the guys, they come back to where they had the pit, where Joseph was, and they're thinking, like, look at this money, and we don't have to worry about Joseph talking to us about us bowing down to him anymore, and him being, Joseph was a good young man. He obeyed God, he obeyed his dad, he did what he was told, and these brothers, they didn't. That, you know, when you're around somebody who's doing what's right, and you're not doing what's right, you don't like being around them. And that's why these brothers, that's one of the reasons the brothers did not like being around Joseph, because Joseph did what was right, and they didn't do what was right. Now, Joseph wasn't going to be around. They could just live however they wanted. Didn't matter what their dad said, they would just do whatever they wanted, and there wouldn't be Joseph there to point out that they weren't doing what was right. Joseph wouldn't be there to tell them that someday they were going to bow down to him. Joseph was gone, and they were happy about that. But guess what happened? Reuben came back. And Reuben comes back, and he looks in the pit. And when he looks in the pit, what does he see? Nothing. It's like, what happened? What happened to Joseph? They said, hey, we sold him. We sold him, and we got 20 pieces of silver. Look at that. And Reuben was like, oh my, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? What's going to happen to Dad? Because everyone knew how much Dad loved Joseph. That's right. And so the guys, they said, but Reuben, look, we got this money. He's not dead. All we got, we don't have to worry about that. We got his coat. It's all tore up here. We ripped it off of him. We just killed one of the hundreds of goats that we have here. Take the blood there. Throw it on the ground. Throw the coat on the ground. Smash it up all around. Just take it to Dad. We don't have to say anything. We just say, does this look like Joseph? No. And Dad will think he must have been killed by a wild animal. And so that's what they decided they would do. And Reuben, even though he knew better, he did it too. He thought, well, I don't know what he thought, but he must have thought, well, this is the plan. And so they took that coat full of dirt and blood back to their dad. They showed it to their dad, and their dad thought, Joseph is dead. A wild animal caught him and ripped him up and killed him. I'm going to be sad for the rest of my life. And he was. for the rest of his life, every day he woke up and thought, I wish Joseph was here. Dead for the rest of his life. And his brothers, they were like, Joseph is gone. But you know what happened to his brothers? And it happens to us too when we do something wrong. A couple days later, in the back of their mind, they were like, I wonder what's going on with Joseph. They didn't say anything, but I wonder what's going on with Joseph. Another year went by, I wonder what's going on with Joseph. Their conscience was telling them. They had a guilty conscience. They knew that they had done wrong, and they had no idea. They were just scared every day something was going to come back to hurt them because they had hurt Joseph. They knew that they had done wrong. Now, when we think about Joseph, if we've read the Bible, there's lots of things about Joseph that remind us of someone else that lived 2,000 years after Joseph. He was even more important than Joseph. And his name is Jesus, right? Yeah. So Jesus came to the earth. Jesus' father loved him. His father sent him to the earth. He came and he lived among people who were his brothers, who were the same country as him, but they hated him. And Jesus knew they hated him. One time Jesus told him a story. He said there was a farmer who had a bunch of crops and he left some servants in charge of left some farmers in charge of his crops, his land, and he went to a far country. And when it was time to get the produce, the crops, the fruit from all of his crops, he sent a servant to those farmers, and the farmers, they just beat his servant and sent him back with nothing. So he sent another servant, and this time they beat this one on the head and bruised his head, and the other one, he barely made it back to the owner of the land. So the owner sent another servant, and this servant, they killed him. Finally, the owner of the land, Jesus is telling the story to the people that lived around, that were with him. And so finally, Jesus said, the owner said to his son, I'm going to send you, they will respect you because you're my son. And so the owner's son went to these farmers, and the farmers, when they saw the owner's son, did they respect him? No. They said, that's the son. If we kill him, we'll be able to keep everything from the guy that moved to the far country. And so they did, Jesus said. And Jesus said, what's going to happen to those farmers when the man comes from the far country? The man is going to punish them. He might even execute them because they killed people. And he's going to let his land out to other people. Now, the rulers of the people that Jesus was talking to, they knew. They knew that Jesus was talking about them, and they got even more upset. Because Jesus was saying, I'm the Son of God. And if Jesus is the Son of God, we have to bow down and worship him, don't we? Because he's God. And these men were saying, that's blasphemy, you're not God. They didn't believe in Jesus at all. And they got upset. They decided that they wanted to kill him. Except, besides the rulers, there was a lot of people that did believe Jesus. So, there's lots of people following Jesus, listening to everything he's saying, believing what he says, believing that he's the Messiah, that he's the Christ, that he's Jesus, that he's God. And then there's these guys, and they don't believe it, and we gotta get him. Finally, one of Jesus' disciples came to the rulers and said, I know you want to catch Jesus. What will you give me if I bring you to Jesus? And what do you think they agreed on? Pieces of silver. For Jesus, it was 30 pieces of silver. They said, we'll give you 30 pieces of silver if you will bring us to him. So Judas was his name. Judas said, all right, I'll bring you to him. And he took him, and he said, I will show you exactly which one of the men is Jesus. And he did. He took him right to him, and they were able to capture Jesus. And Judas saw that they had captured him. They saw some of the ways they began to treat him, and Judas started thinking, I didn't think they would do this. Judas took that money and said, here, I don't want this money anymore. But did Judas, what... Did they take it?
No.
So Judas just threw it on the ground and he went out and he killed himself. He hung himself. He didn't have to do that. He could have repented. He could have turned. Would Jesus have forgiven Judas for betraying him? Jesus will forgive everybody. But you got to come to him. Was Judas forgiven for his sin? No. But everybody can be forgiven for their sin because Jesus died for everyone's sins. And everybody who will turn from their sin and believe on Jesus, Jesus will forgive their sins. And he will make it so that they can pray and talk to God the Father in heaven and have fellowship with him. So when we think about Joseph, so many things happen in Joseph's life that reminds us of Jesus. Now, Joseph is in a caravan on his way to Egypt. Right? That is trouble, because it's not vacation for him, is it? He's a slave. That is big trouble, but the verse says, but God was with him and delivered him out of all his afflictions. How did God do that in Egypt? We're going to have to find out next week. So you can read the Bible, or you can think back to when you learned about this in Sunday school or something on your own. That's fine. But if you know it that well, maybe Ian, you want to tell the lesson next week? Maybe. Different personalities. Anybody else want to tell the lesson next week? Not, they're all looking the other way. All right, so next week we're going to find out, how did God deliver him out of all his afflictions? Or was there even more afflictions for Joseph? Could he get into more trouble than being a slave? We'll have to see next week.